Hey. So I said I would do a Q&A video, and here it is. So the first question is, what's your middle name? My middle name is Rose, like the flower I have on my arm. The last time you laughed so hard you cried. Maybe like a couple nights ago, I was with my friend at Steak and Shake at like 1 in the morning. And she was trying to fold a dollar bill into something because she left like $2 for a tip. And she was trying to fold the dollar bills into something for the waitress. So, yeah, she failed very badly, but it was hilarious. Best meal you can cook? I don't really cook. I mean, I can, but I don't like to because I have extreme anxiety around raw foods. So, I think probably like, oh, this isn't really cooking, but I make really good peanut butter cookies. I mean, it's baking, but I got the recipe from my grandma, and she taught me how to make them when I was really, really young. And they are little peanut butter, like round cookies, and you stick a Hershey Kiss in the middle of it after they come out of the oven so that it melts, and it is so, so good. Whenever I make them, they last like a day at most, because I can make like 2 dozen and they're all gone within a day. It's crazy. My family loves sweets. Why did you get a tattoo? So, if you all didn't know, this is another question. I am 17 years old. So my mom had to sign for all of my tattoos, and I have 3 at the moment. Might be getting another one soon, crossing my fingers. But my mom is kind of hesitant to let me because she's like, you don't need tattoos, you're only 17. But I'm lucky enough to have a great mom that gives me some freedom. But yeah, I got a tattoo because I just have always liked them. I think they're an incredible way to express yourself, and I think they can be art if they're done properly, and I just like them. So I got one. Well, 3. But yeah, this is my other one, one of my other ones. And then the rose tattoo that I showed earlier, and then I have a panther on my leg, which I can't really show you at the moment because that would be kind of hard to show. Anyways, I'm really bad at talking, so yeah. What is your dream career? Anything in the world? To be honest, I would love to open my own animal shelter. I've always loved animals and grew up with animals, and I just love helping them. Like, my dream job would be driving around the neighborhoods and picking up stray animals and bringing them to my house, but I would end up with like thousands of dogs and cats. So, yeah, I'd love to open an animal shelter. There's a quote in my bio, and someone asked what book it's from, and the quote is by John Green, and it's actually not a quote from a book. It's a quote from one of the videos that he made. I think it's one of his gaming videos. And I didn't know that. I had to look it up because I've just seen the quote all over Tumblr and I fell in love with it, so I put it in my bio. But I will link the video down below if you guys want to check it out. I think it's at the 13-minute mark, so if you skip forward, then he'll like say the quote at around that time. But it's kind of funny because it's in the middle of him gaming, so he's like, he inserts like little things in between the quote that's totally unrelated because, anyways. Have you thought about your future kids' names? If yeah, what are they? Yes, I have a really long list on my phone of kids' names because I want a ton of kids. So I will pull that up and I'll just name a few. So for girls, I really like the name Eliana. I like the name Evelina. Magnolia, I think, is really pretty. Charlotte. And then for boys, I have Sebastian, Caden, Blake, Dylan are a few that I really love. Yeah, I have like a crazy amount of names. My house is going to be filled with children, hopefully. And this is related, but it wasn't a question. But I want to adopt most of my kids, so. What's your favorite song or music to bump in your car? I'm guessing that means like blast, like to dance to while you're driving or something. Recently, that has been Taylor Swift. I love her newest album. And I was obsessed with Shake It Off for a long time, and now that her new music, like the rest of the album, has been released, I've been obsessed with that. So, yeah. That. You had a surgery a while ago. How are you feeling now? For those of you who didn't know, I had surgery. I think it's been, a month and a half, I think. I have always had, this is probably TMI, but whatever. I've always had, really irregular periods, and so finally I got tired of it and went to my gynecologist. And he tried to figure out what was wrong and couldn't figure it out, so then the like last resort was surgery, exploratory surgery. And he went in through my belly button with a scope and found that I have endometriosis, which is where there are like there's like tissue or like uterine tissue outside of your uterus, and it's really painful. And so he burned the cells off, or the tissue, he burned it off, and hopefully that will help with the irregularity and the pain. How am I feeling now? I've pretty much recovered. Sometimes when I stretch, it still kind of hurts in my belly button area because it, like, they use glue to seal it instead of stitches, and which is really weird. I've never heard of that before, but yeah, it's all healed now and it's not like sore anymore, but sometimes when I stretch, it kind of hurts. But as far as how I'm feeling, I feel pretty good for the most part. If you could change your birthday, what would you change it to? Honestly, I think my birthday is pretty cool. I have Cinco de Mayo as my birthday, and my favorite number is 5 because of that, because it's 5-5, for those of you who didn't know. I mean, I don't celebrate Cinco de Mayo, but I just think it's cool that it's like a holiday on my birthday. But if I could change it, I think it would be awesome to have a winter birthday because I love winter. But I'm pretty happy with my birthday. Yeah. What month would you like to get married in? I would love to get married in the fall. I have always dreamed of having a fall wedding, like October, November-ish. Maybe September, but I like the like when the leaves are changing and it's just starting to get colder and you can go outside with a sweater and that's my favorite kind of weather. So yeah, I'd love to get married in the fall. If you could have any animal as a pet in the world, what would it be? To be honest, I don't really find the appeal in having a pet other than like domesticated animals because they require a lot of special care. And I don't think it's right to take them out of their natural habitat and try and like contain their wildness, whatever. I think you get what I mean. I don't think that I would choose any animal that wasn't already domesticated, like a dog or a cat or something, but right now I would love to get a pet rat. I just think they're so cute, and my mom hates rodents, so she won't let me get them, but maybe when I move out, if I have time, because I don't want to get a pet if I don't have time for them, because that's just not fair to them. How do you feel about guys proclaiming to be feminist, and do you consider yourself to be a feminist? I think anyone can be a feminist. It doesn't matter whether they're a guy or a girl. I think the most important thing is, because a lot of stereotypes are surrounding the word feminism, because a lot of people think that it means tearing men down instead of building women up. And a lot of people think that being a feminist means like hating men and that kind of thing. So, but if you really look up the definition of feminism, it's the fact that they have equal rights, not the fact that men are having rights taken away from them to make room for women, if that makes sense. So I think as long as they claim, like, as long as they practice what they claim, then it doesn't matter. And that's for everyone, not just guys. So, do you consider yourself to be a feminist? I think I would, yeah. But I think it's important to, I don't, it's kind of hard to explain. I feel like a lot of people get caught up in the bandwagon. Like, right now, feminism is a huge thing in society, but it's like being blown up. And I think it's important for people to maintain that belief system, not just because it's popular right now. And for me personally, I think it shouldn't be something that's really celebrated because it should have been already there. Like, it's kind of like, I don't feel like people should be praised for doing the right thing necessarily because it should just be common sense at this point. I don't know if that makes sense, but yeah, I would consider myself a feminist. I think that women should have the same rights as men, and men the same rights as women, in that I think men should be able to talk about their feelings without feeling like they're any less of a man, and I think they should know how to cook and how to clean and take care of themselves, and I think women should be able to change a tire, and I think I'm so tired of gender stereotypes, like gender roles, where people think that, oh, they're a man, so they have to know how to do this, or, like, I think it all depends on the person, not the gender. So I'm just kind of going on a tangent now, but yeah. How and why did you break up with your boyfriend? This is kind of a personal question, and I don't want to get into detail because I still respect him as a person, but basically, we just weren't compatible. And he's still one of my good friends, and we still talk, so yeah. What? Oh, sorry. How can we pray for you? So I'm saying a lot. I'm sorry. I say that when I can't figure out to say like what I'm thinking. So I could be moving soon, and I could use prayers that it all goes smoothly. My uncle just got out of the hospital after 2.5 weeks of having a tube down his throat. So pray that he continues to get better. For those of you who don't know, he was diagnosed with stage 3 melanoma a few months ago. So I could use prayers for that. My mom is really stressed out lately about the living situation and money, so pray for her. Other than that, I think. Oh. I'm thinking about dropping my college classes. I'm taking. Oh my gosh, my eye. I think I have something in it, but. Sorry. I'm thinking about dropping my college classes. I'm taking community college classes. And right now things are just really stressful and hard, and I don't think that it's the right time for me to be in college. I'm the kind of person that if I'm not 100% committed to it, then it just won't work. Like, I put a lot into what I do, and right now I just don't have the time or energy to put into school, and I think that college is not everyone is supposed to go to college, and a lot of people don't understand that kind of viewpoint because they're like, you can never know too much and you can never like get enough schooling. And for the people that go to college, good for you. Like, I'm not judging you or any, and for the people that don't go to college, I'm not judging you either. It's all based on the personal preference, but for me, I just don't feel like it's the right time. And so I'm thinking about dropping them so I could use prayers for that. And the last question is, who would you like to see do a Q&A video next? So, I know Year of the Lamb did one. Oh my gosh, I don't know how to say her username, but I'll link the Q&A videos that I've seen down below for you guys to check them out. I would love to see Dahlia do one. Hi, Dahlia, if you're watching this. I would love to see. Oh my gosh, I got a haircut in my hand. I'm not smooth at all. I would love to see you do one. Yeah, any other people that Like, I can never think of things on the spot, but any other people that I want to do one next, I will tag in the, what's it called? Description of the Tumblr post that I will have this video in. So, yeah, this is at 20 minutes now, so I've been rambling kind of, and for those of you who are still watching, thank you. You are the real MVP. Yeah, so thanks for watching, and you guys can keep sending me questions if you want. I will answer them on my Tumblr. But that's about it, so I will see you guys later. Bye.